All right, let's get back up for our next speaker. Let's get the energy up. Let's get excited. We got a couple more speakers to wrap up the day. Our next speaker has been in the industry for less than 6 years and has a total agency sales volume of over $18 million. In March of 2022, he earned just south. I don't know if I'm supposed to share this or not, but I guess it's my event. It's my stage. I'm going to share it anyway. Just south of $200,000 in a month. He speaks on having a CEO mindset. From Boise, Idaho, 8%, get on your feet, transfer some energy, tell me welcome to the stage. From Idaho to Dallas, Darin Stubbs.
Oh, the misery. Everybody wants to be my enemy. Spare the sympathy. Everybody wants to be my enemy.
Yo.
Look out for yourself, my enemy. Look out for yourself,
but I'm ready.
Right, your words up you on the wall, okay? As you're praying all for right. My phone, and the laughter in the halls, and the names that
it's
I've been
exciting. Told. I get my Facebook Live in, right? You know, free advertising, get out there, 5,000 people on Facebook. Well, thank you. First, I want to say thank you to Cody and the amazing 8% Nation team and all the guys in the back and the sound and all the staff and everybody. You have no idea how many people are working behind the scenes to put this on. So thank you, Cody, to your amazing staff and everyone. My name is Darin Stubbs. Let's see, get my slides going here. No, that's not it. This one? No, hello. What are we doing here? Okay, well, Cody, are we not working here now? Well, all right. There we go. We're way off. That's not the beginning. Oh, there we go. Okay, there we go. Okay, thank you. So I'm Darin Stubbs from Boise, Idaho. I am Executive Vice President with Symmetry Financial Group. Actually, this is my 6th anniversary. I signed my contract 6 years ago this week, started August 1st of 2016 with Symmetry. And man, it has been an amazing ride. Cody and I did a fantastic interview on the podcast, and I've just gotten amazing feedback from that. Thank you, Cody. I've got a kind of an interesting story. You might want to catch that. Check that out. But today, what I want to talk about is mindset. So those of you that are brand new, first time being an entrepreneur, brand new in the business, you never really run a business before, and you really have to have a mindset change. And I think that if I can figure out how to work this doggone, there we go. All right. So finally figure out which buttons are going where. We're in good shape now. But in the beginning, you have to take a look at, stop thinking like an employee, start thinking like an entrepreneur. There's some words and phrases and mindset things that you have to take a look and change that mindset. In the beginning, if you come from a paycheck mentality, you have to start thinking in terms of profit mentality. Scarcity versus abundance. You know, I found that most people who are poor, and I love what John had to say about time, because we all have 168 hours in a week. All of us have the same amount. The poorest person, Elon Musk, the richest person, 168 hours in a week. So how do you manage your time? And for me, I'm a Google Calendar guy. So my kids growing up, I've always been self-employed. They said, well, Dad, you're the boss. I said, well, no, actually my Google Calendar's the boss. And whatever's in my Google Calendar, man, that's what I do. If it's in there, it's done. If it says I have an appointment at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, then I set an alarm for 5:15 and I'm out of bed. And you have to have a serious commitment to a non-negotiable calendar. That's one of the very first things you have to do. Because most of us come from a job background, right? And what does your boss tell you what to do? Tells you when to be there, tells you when you can go to the bathroom, tells you when you can go to lunch, tells you when you can go home, tells you when and where you can go on vacation, because they decide how much money you get paid. The other thing you have to switch in your mind is stop thinking about, oh, leads cost so much. Well, I can't spend money on that. You're gonna learn to invest money, especially on leads. That's like the gas that goes in the Ferrari of your car. Put out 500, deposit 5 grand. I mean, how many weeks a year would you do that? Put out $500 on quality leads and deposit $5,000 a week. That's a huge return, 10 to 1. So that's the kind of mindset you want to look at. So let's start with some A words. Well, we already heard this one. These three A words can change your life, and the best part is they're all free. It costs you nothing. Every day you get to wake up and decide what your attitude is. Someone cuts you off in traffic, well, maybe they're going to the hospital with their son broken arm. I don't know. You can freak out if you want, or you can just say, hey, you know what? I'm not going to let that bother me. When you're on the phone, let me tell you the worst that's ever gonna happen to you. F off, don't call me back, click. Okay, if you can handle that, you can make millions of dollars in the insurance industry. That is the worst it's ever going to be. Me, when someone says that, that no means go. I'm on to the next one, right? Because I'm really good at taking action. You control your attitude. You control action. You control activity would be another good word for that. And there's something else, too, is you got to learn to control who you associate with. And right now, you're in a room full of winners. So congratulations to you for choosing to invest, to be here at 8% Nation and get good association. And along something, another acronym I didn't put in the slideshow, I'll just slip it in real quick, DBE. D, delete. B, block. E, erase. Anyone gives me any crap or drama, DBE, gone. I have no drama in my life. Because there are naysayers, they're going to say, you can't make it, Josh. You're not good enough. Oh, that thing won't work for you, John. You're not going to make it. Man, just eliminate those people right out of your life because their time sucks. The other thing, too, it's important to understand is your whole world has changed. If you are an entrepreneur and you are starting an agency, even if you're working with an IMO and you're brand new or a brand new agent right at the beginning, something happens. Did you know the dollars in your pocket just got worth 30% more? See, because an employee, this is what broke people do. They earn money. The government confiscates that in the form of taxes. That's why it's called confiscatory tax system. And then you spend what's left. Wealthy people earn money. Then they spend money and invest that money into their business, pre-tax dollars, and then you're taxed on what's left. So it's kind of like realizing, wait a second, what's a pre-tax dollar versus an after-tax dollar? Well, a pre-tax dollar is a dollar is worth a dollar. An after-tax dollar, that's worth about 70%, maybe less, depending upon your income tax bracket. But you already have a cell phone bill, right? You already have expenses and things that modem. Cable modem, gas, car, all that stuff. You can start to pay these things and think like a CEO. Pay them with pre-tax dollars. Tax deduct those expenses. Well, that's a nice 30% pay raise right there. You're going to have expenses in your business. You can expect that. There will be expenses. Fixed expenses. Variable fixed expense. I had a guy say, well, Darin, what's that? What's a variable fixed expense? That's kind of like an oxymoron. I'm like, no, it's not. Because I'm going to invest into leads every single week. But I might change my spend from my floor to the middle to the high, depending upon where I'm at in my budget and my appointment calendar. But that's one of the things you're going to invest in every single week. Profit, like variable expenses, hey, maybe you went to dinner on this event. Hey, if you're on a hotel and you flew and you're overnight, you get the tax deduct that. Airline tickets, all that stuff. You have to start to think in terms of profit and loss versus paycheck mentality. Paycheck mentality is what broke people do. You all know there's a difference between broke and poor, right? What's poor? Well, that's mindset. Oh, we're poor. Broke is just a temporary reflection of the integers in your current bank account balance. And when I lost everything, if you saw my story, bankrupt, foreclosure, the whole deal, and I was whining to my mother, oh, we have to sell our motorcycles and our boat and all this crap, and my mom said, hey, listen, at least when you were good money, you always pay cash for everything, so be grateful because you're going to sell a motorcycle and feed your four children for the next month. And I thought, well, that's pretty good logic. And you start to think of the difference of broke and poor, because I told my 10-year-old daughter at the time, hey, go ride that motorcycle one more time because we're going to sell it. And she said, why? And I said, well, Daddy's losing his job. And she said, well, hand on her hip, well, you can't lose your job, Dad. You're the boss man. Because I was the CEO of a mortgage banking company. Anybody in the mortgage business in 2008, 2009, 2010? Yeah, a bunch of us went bankrupt. I said, well, honey, actually, Daddy's out of a job. And then she said, are we going to be poor? I said, don't ever say that word. We are never poor. We're going to be broke. And it was a hard journey back, I'll tell you that. The other thing, too, is don't steal from your agency. I see a lot of mentors and coaches in the room. And we'll teach a new agent how to make money. And the first mistake you do is what? Go spend all your money. You just stole from yourself. You've got to leave some money in there, returned earnings, so that you can invest next week into the business. Me, I teach best practices banking. Now, I'm not here to give tax advice or legal advice. I'm not a licensed CPA or attorney, so, you know, there's the legal disclaimer. But I have multiple bank accounts at Chase Bank. All the money comes into my operating account from all the deposits, 6, 8, 10, 15 deposits a day go into one place. Then I have a payroll account. Yeah, I have myself on a payroll. I use ADP payroll. I pay myself the salary and pay the maximum tax on that. And I have staff, people that work for me. In fact, they're in the room over there. They get their paycheck. It's all electronic. Then I have a taxes account where I start moving money to pay future taxes, because let me tell you, this insurance industry thing can get out of control financially in a very good way. But if you start looking at your deposits, 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60,000 a month, and you're not putting money away for taxes, you are going to have a nasty problem on your hands. And that is a call from the IRS you do not want. So plan ahead for that. Best practices in accounting and payroll. And then I kind of have a travel and expense fund, so I different things like that, and I use one credit card to play the Sky Miles game like a lot of people in this room. We got hundreds of thousands of Sky Miles. Melanie flew out for free. We upgraded a hotel room for free just because of the Sky Miles. So have some good practices on how you manage your money and keep track of that stuff, because I don't want to see you getting behind and then have that nasty call from you-know-who where they come in and they take money out of your account. And then have a personal account. Things like dry cleaning, groceries, pay for those things. So don't commingle your money. Think like a CEO, because 6 years ago I started my business. This week, 6 years ago, it was me. I had no pipeline of business, no pipeline agents. And in 6 years, I've made millions of dollars in personal income. In fact, this year, I'll probably clear $1.2 million in personal income because I've simply followed the system and the process. So someone can start, and I didn't have a credit card 7 years ago, and it was a tough journey. But I think if you're new, never take more than 50% out of your business, especially that first year or two. Well, I have bills to pay. Great. Pay yourself first, invest in some more leads, generate some more appointments, go close some more business, take that money and pay your bills. Don't drain out your bank account. Now, you guys have all seen the cash flow quadrant, Robert Kiyosaki. But I kind of insurance-sized this a little bit. Employees, that's 85% of the population. You know the 40 for 40 plan? Work 40 hours a week for 40 years of your life. Get out to age 65 and what are you? Dead, broken, or selling fishing licenses at Walmart. That's what I thought might happen to me. But you're still trading time for dollars. Well, self-employed people, that's great, because I've been self-employed a lot of my life, but you could be the plumber, the dentist, the mortgage loan officer, the self-employed individual agent. But if you're the dentist, you still have to drill, fill, and bill. You're still trading time for dollars. One of my good friends who's finally getting his license, 30 years Southwest Airlines, he had a heart problem last year, had to have a stent put in. That guy could run a marathon, he's just buff, 60 years old. The FAA grounded him. He went from $40,000 a month to $2,300 a month in disability, just like that. And he was sitting in my house last July, 4th of July weekend, and he goes, now I finally get what you've been trying to tell me, Darin. If my ass is not sitting in the seat flying that 737 for Southwest Airlines, I'm not making any money. He goes, where am I gonna go at 60 years old to make 40 grand a month? I'm like, you know, I've been trying to get you to get your license. I think he schedules an exam next week, finally. But it's that time for dollars. Self-employed, same type of thing. You're still trading time for dollars. Business owners, well, that's where your income is no longer dependent upon you. You have people that make money for you. Intellectual property makes money for you. Resources make money for you. That's where you can really start to take a look at ROI, return on investment. ROO, return on opportunity. ROT, return on time. And then, hey, after a while, pretty soon, your money starts to make money for you. You get into that 1% club. We have enough cash. We can start to invest into real estate or crypto or, you know, any of the number of things you can want to invest into. So what is the IMO type business? Well, I happen to be with Symmetry, so I look at it this way. It's the ladder. It takes you from the bottom corner over here as a self-employed new agent, small agency, to a business over there. We have a large agency where you're producing tens of thousands of dollars a month in residuals and overrides. And it's astounding because it really doesn't take that long. Think in your mind right now, how many years have you been working on your job, your career? If you stop work today, what's your income tomorrow? For all the years, the hours and sacrifice you put in. Big fat zero, right? Unless you're in the insurance industry. So is it worth it to work hard for a few years to have something that's the most precious commodity of all? Buy your time back. And here's what that looks like. Okay, X, Y, time going this way, income going that way. In the beginning, you have no agents. Most people start with maybe one or two or a handful. I know there's some people that switch big IMO to another. I know that's a little bit different. I'm talking about people that have to build it organically from the beginning. And see, for me, I went out into the field and top producer. And in the beginning, that's where your income's gonna come from. Don't try to ride your three agents, the overrides from your three agents into the crown. That's not how it works. You see, the income and overrides from the long-term residuals, that takes time for you to develop. But the thing is there's far more money on the other side of that intersectional line. And for me, that line in the middle was 2 years and 20 grand a month. Because even though I was good in the field, I knew I didn't want to be in the field for life. I knew I wanted to be able to buy my freedom and go out and do more mentoring and coaching and training and these types of events versus being on the phone and selling. Although Melly and I, it was her idea. We just spent a month on Catalina Island. She said, March, hey, let's do it. I'm like, we can't do that. She goes, why not? And I went, have laptop, have Wi-Fi, have cell phone. You're right. So we closed our house in Boise, bought $7,000 in e-bikes, loaded up one of our vehicles, drove all the way to Long Beach, jumped on the boat, rented this amazing house, and I still closed a $700,000 annuity, still made $62,000 in overrides and residuals. Why play with my grandkids on the beach? Because I bought my freedom. I bought my time back. But it's gonna take a couple of years. You got it? You're not gonna go out this thing for a week and then suddenly, poof, that's it. No, it's gonna take some time. And I like every other speaker before me has been great, but luck is where opportunity and preparedness meet. Do you realize how lucky you are to be in this room today? Man, you are experiencing luck in real time today. That's amazing. All right, so this is how you think life is. Life is fair. I have news for you. Life is not fair. Stuff happens. You get the balance of life, right? Everything you want's on that side. Gosh, if I coulda, woulda, shoulda, if I'd only. You know, some people look back in life and they should all over themselves. I should have gone to that 8% nation. I should have listened to that call. I should have made some more dials. You know, my Google Calendar said to dial till 8 p.m., but I wimped out at 7:15 because I just felt like wimping out. I should have just actually followed through. Because in life, to get what you want, it takes units of work. Darin, I've been working. How come I'm not wealthy yet? Well, you haven't done enough work yet, so you stay at it. Nothing's happening, man. I'm working. Well, you're making deposits. Your team is growing, but you haven't done enough work to tip the scale in your favor. But after a while, people get to hear. And that's exciting. And then a lot of people, guess what they do? They let their foot off the gas and they're back. I've arrived. I'm an agency owner. I'm an agency manager. I'm finally making 15 grand a month in residuals. I don't have to work anymore. And then bam, backwards you go. Anybody experience that? Let me tell you, it's easier to just stay focused because you have to do the work to get back to where you were. And then after a while, bam. You see, in the beginning, you're adding agents. Some are coming, some are going. Who's experienced that? Recruited 3, lost 4. Recruited 7, lost 3. Okay? But after a while, over time, it starts to multiply for you. And that's where it gets a lot of fun. So, what's this? Come on, shout it out. What is this? Thermometer. What does a thermometer do? Temperature, it reacts to the environment, right? When it's hot, it's up there. When it's not, it's down there. Some of you live your life like that. Up and down and up and down. My God, that's no way to live. What's that? Thermostat. What does a thermostat do? It controls the temperature. It sets the temperature. Except we argue about that constantly. Like most couples, I'm dripping wet in sweat. She's freezing in 4 blankets. Anybody else's household like that? Right? Ladies are like, oh man, we're dying. But you need to learn to control your emotions, ladies and gentlemen. And be determined. Live your life like a thermostat. Set the setting. Stay focused. If it's hot, man, you just keep plugging away. Bam, 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 bam. Yes, take a break and enjoy the journey. But boy, if you live your life building your agency like a thermometer, this is not going to be a very fun business. I'll tell you that right now. So I hope that you can learn to control that mental part because it's mostly in the mind. It's mostly in your mind. If you think making dials is hard, congratulations, you're right, it's hard for you. Not hard for me. I kind of like it. And yes, I've heard every swear word you can think of 1,000 times. And I have a little ritual. I've got all the fancy stuff on the computer, but I still, when I do dial, I still like to print leads. Although I don't do leads anymore, and most of my stuff is referral now, which is great. You just stay long enough and you get wave 2 of recruits and wave 2 of business because your friends are like, wow, he's been at this for a while and they're doing really well. Maybe I should roll my 401k over with Darin in one of those fixed index annuities. Anybody else getting lots of phone calls for that this year besides me? Millions of dollars. It's been like free money. It's incredible. And you stay out there and you stay after it and people will come to you. But if you don't put the time in initially and stay consistent, you'll never get the multiplier. Something else to think about. We're all a bunch of rugged entrepreneurs, right? Who wants a boss? Yeah, none of us. Me, I'm the nicest guy in the world. You ask me to do something? Probably, sure, no problem, you bet. Tell me what to do? Oh, man, hairs on the back of my neck and my middle finger start to rise. And I'm like, man, I do not want to be told what to do. The Rock, if you ask me something, yeah, sure, Rock, you need some help moving that table? Yeah, let's do it. Let's knock it out. Let's roll. Hey, Darin, get your butt over there and move that table. Yeah, you know what? That's coming out of my mouth, right? You're probably the same way. Manager, mentor. I mean, do you want to manage your agents? Or do you want to mentor and coach them and help them to become better people? And see, something I added to this recently, submission versus surrender. When you go to work for a boss, what are you doing? You're submitting. You're letting them have authority over your life. Their thumb comes down on you. They say jump, you better do it. What about surrender? That implies choice. I love the Latin phrase, cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am. You see, when I got started in this 6 years ago, I decided I am going to succeed. I am going to move up. I am going to get a pay raise. And that's the beauty about what you're here today. You get to surrender to a system and choose to follow that and make that happen. Because let me tell you, marriage is hard. Divorce is hard. Choose your heart. Being fat is hard. Being fit is hard. Choose your heart. Communication is hard. Not communicating is hard. Choose your heart. Being broke is hard. Being wealthy is hard. Choose your heart. Life's never going to be easy. It's always going to be hard. The best part is each of us get to choose what we do. So, I forgot to put on my slide. If you want to reach out to me, workinsurancenow.com. That should have been on my first slide. That's my fault. Workinsurancenow.com, that's how you get a hold of me. But I want to leave you with this last thought. And sorry, I haven't corrected the pronouns, because this is how I memorized this 30 years ago in college. You are the fellow that has to decide whether you do it or toss it aside. You are the fellow that makes up your mind whether you lead or linger behind, whether you stretch for the goal that's afar or just be content to stay right where you are. Think it over, ladies and gentlemen, because it's really all up to you. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Darin Stubbs.
Everybody wants to be my enemy.
Don't worry, buddy. What's that? Thank you, buddy.
Everybody wants to be my enemy.